now we go into the topic of air pollution, which we have slightly discussed about in the previous videos, but we don't directly mention it as air pollution. So we can separate the air pollution subtopic from atmospheric chemistry from this definition that I'm going to read here. Severe air pollution episodes occur when the rates of emissions or formation of pollutants greatly exceed the rates at which the pollutants are dispersed by winds and vertical transport or are removed from the atmosphere by chemical reactions or deposition, basically sinks. So if the rates of emission or the formation of these are more than the processes that are able to remove them, which increase their concentration, then it becomes an air pollution episode or an air pollution issue or condition. It means that heightened concentration values is what constitute as air pollution. So the rate of emission or the rate of formation minus the sink, if it's positive and greatly positive, then it increases, this condition would accumulate the gases or aerosols in the atmosphere, the concentration of the gases and aerosol in the atmosphere, and that increase the overall concentration, which anything that is too much of would be detrimental to biological health or to the environment as a whole. Now, the main sources of these gases or aerosols mainly come from combustion processes, such as emissions from power plants, smelters, automobiles or transport, etc. And these sources would release high concentrations of carbon monoxide due to incomplete combustion, carbon dioxide, which is not technically an air pollutant or a gas that is can be considered as an air pollutant, but is a greenhouse gas. And then they also release nitrogen oxides, which can form ozone, as we see in the reactive nitrogen compounds in the atmosphere topic, and also these processes will release sulfur dioxide. Now, high temperature emissions of temperature more than 3,500 Kelvin, because from the engines or from the furnace or the combustion section of those combustion sources are very hot. They because they combust the fossil fuel. These temperatures, high temperatures, would oxidize N2 to NO, and that's where nitrogen oxides come from. But and this NO is basically unstable, and they would change to nitrogen dioxide in the atmosphere. So the nitrogen oxide emissions are a combination of nitrogen oxide as well as nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen oxides play a key role in the formation of photochemical smog. And coal combustion and heavy metal smelters would then emit sulfur dioxide. So these are some of the main sources of sulfur dioxide, mainly coming from anthropogenic sources, although there are natural sources such as from volcanoes or from windblown dust because of strong winds over barren land. But those have been addressed in the earlier videos, and these are the ones specifically coming from human sources.